Let's look at the introduction to Python programming language. The learning objectives. After this lecture, you will be able to answer what Python is, describe features of Python, describe the process of writing and executing programs. Python is an interpreted, object-oriented, high-level programming language. Slowly, we will learn these terms, interpreted, object-oriented, and high-level programming language. Little history. Developed by Guido van Rossum. Released in the early 1990s. The name Python is based on 1970s British comedy sketch television show, Monty Python's Flying Circus. Let's look at various features of this language. Python is an easy to learn language. It has few keywords, simple structure, and a clearly defined syntax. This allows beginners to pick up the language quickly. Python has a simple syntax. Thus, Python code is more clearly defined and easy to read. Though simple, Python provides powerful programming features and is widely used by companies like YouTube, Google, Yahoo, NASA, and many academic research groups. Python is well supported and is freely available at www.python.org. Python supports the development of a wide range of applications, from simple text processing to web applications to GUI-based applications. Python is interactive. This means we can directly interact with the Python interpreter, executing instructions and seeing their effect one at a time. Let's learn few basics of programming. First, what is a program? A program is a set of instructions that a computer can understand and execute. So, if I wish to execute anything on a computer, I need to give an instruction to the computer. When I collect or when I make a set of these instructions, that we call as a program. For writing programs, we require a programming language. Thus, a programming language is a notation using which we can write programs. Programming languages are normally written using an English-like language because it is convenient for us to understand such a language. So, such languages we call as high-level programming language. The problem is computers do not understand high-level programming languages. They only understand binary zeros and ones. Thus, the language that the computer understands is called as machine-level language. And what we need is that programs written in high-level language should be translated into binary form or machine level language. For this, we require a special software called as a translator. So, let's learn this process of translation. Translation is a process of converting high level language into machine level language. We will study two of its types. First is compilers, second is interpreters. So, let's look at compiler. In a compiler, we give a program that is written in high-level language, and a compiler, which is a software, it generates a program equivalent to the program that is written here, but in machine-level language. This program is then executed over the CPU. The program may require some data that is given as input, and the program may generate some output. Okay, so that we see here. Let's take an example and understand this whole process of compilation. So, we have a compiler here. There is a program written in high-level language. So, when I say input A, value for some entity A is given through the keyboard. Similarly, value for some entity B is also given through the keyboard. The third statement is adding the value for A and value for B, and this value is getting stored in an entity called as S. and then we are printing whatever is inside S. Now when I give this program to the compiler, compiler generates something like this. Okay, zeros and ones or binary form of the program that is written here. This program is then executed over the CPU. So if you look at this program, it requires two inputs, value for A, value for B. So let's say from the keyboard, I have typed 10, which becomes the value for A, and 20, which becomes the value for B. When the input is given to this program is going to take 10 and 20, add both of them and store it in S. So therefore, the output that is generated is 30. Let's look at the second type of translator called as an interpreter. Okay. So here, interpreter also takes the same input program written in high level language. But what interpreter does is, it takes one statement at a time from the program, converts it into machine level language and immediately executes it. So that is why interpreter works in tandem with the CPU. Takes one statement, converts it into machine form and then executes it immediately on the CPU. The result is that we do not see an explicit generation of machine level language program here in the interpreter as we saw in the compiler. So because it is converting and executing one statement at a time, the data also is given to the interpreter and you would also see the output generated. Okay. So let's see an example. Here we have the same program that we saw for the compiler given to the interpreter. Interpreter will take the first statement, convert it into machine form and immediately takes 10 as the value for A from the user. Then takes the second one, converts it into machine form, takes 20 from the user and stores it as a value for B. Then third statement is taken, converted into machine form and executed immediately, that would result in adding 10 and 20 and storing 30 in S. Then the final statement is taken, converted into machine form, executed, and that results in 30 as the output. So there is no change in how the input is given or how the output is generated. The change is in how the execution of the program is happening. Python, as we saw in the initial slide, is an interpreted programming language. So this is the model that you're going to see when you're writing programs in Python and executing them. Now for executing or for writing and executing the programs in Python, we will be using an environment called as IDLE, which is an integrated development environment on a Windows system. So what is IDLE? It is a bundled set of software tools which we are going to use for development of programs. And what all it includes? So it typically includes an editor. So first thing that I require is that I need to write programs. So for writing programs or for making changes to those programs, we would require an editor. The second thing that we would require is a translator, because these programs need to be executed. So you need to convert them into machine form and execute. For that, we would require a translator. And the third that would be included in an IDLE or an integrated development environment is a program debugger that will help me in finding errors in my programs. Okay, so let's see how IDLE works. So from the start search for IDLE, that is what you would type. It will give you IDLE, whichever Python version you have installed on your machine. Press an enter key and it opens what we call as a Python shell. Okay. You will see that at the top, and here there is a cursor blinking at these three greater than signs which are called as Python shell prompt. So at this shell prompt, you can give any valid Python statement. So something like this, 2 plus 3 and it generates the result, that is 5. Okay. So let's take few more examples. 2 raised to 100. So 2 star star 100 means 2 raised to 100, that is executed. Okay. I can execute any valid Python statement here. So I may write some for loop here. Let's say, and here I'm printing the value of I. Okay, and done. So I press an enter key. One more time I press an enter key and these statements are executed. So any valid Python statement I give here, it gets executed. Now what if I want to write a program? So let's write our first Python program. So here we go to file, we choose new file. When we do that, there is another window that opens. This is the editor where we are going to write the program. So let's write a program, the same one that we have seen in the slide. So we write a equal to input. Okay, enter. And we need to convert it into an integer. Subsequently, you learn the meaning of all this. So we write like this, and then we write b is equal to int input. Okay, enter b, and then we find the sum of a and b, and then we want to print. So we write sum is, and we print. So we have typed some program. Okay, we need to save this. So we say alt f, and then we say save or save as, anything you can choose. Okay, you can choose whichever folder you want to, wherever you want to save it. Let's save it here. Okay, so I am saving it as first. The extension of this file will be .py. Okay, so it will automatically save it as first.py, and I click on save. So you'll see the file is saved as first.py. Now how do I execute? Editor job is done. I have written a program. Now using the editor, let's execute the program. So for executing, we will go to run, and then we will choose run module. There is also a shortcut F5 which you can choose. So we say run module, and you'll see that I am brought back to the Python shell. Okay, so restart indicates that the program has started the execution. So first it is asking me to enter the value of a, so I enter 10, then it takes the value of b, and it prints sum is 30, and I am at the shell prompt. I can go back to the editor, make changes, or I may want to write another program. So here I say file, new file, another editor opens. So using an idle, I can open multiple editors, work with multiple programs at a time. We stop here.